Ladies and gentlemen, I'm come from Benin. Benin is a country, West Africa. Benin was a colony by French people. Excuse me, I do not speak good English, but the slides can't allow you to follow me. So, I have the honor to present the synthesis of step one of a study of implementation of palmyra and rattan wood in structure of the slab to hollow body of economic housing. Therefore, the research work is underway to achieve it full scale implementation. It is an opportunity to tell the participants of this symposium that we are looking for research funding for main project. This communication will be presented according to the plan below. Context, justification, and problematic. Objective, the works, the typology of the building using palmyra wood according to traditional practice during the colonial period in Africa. A few mechanical and physical characteristics of wood, palm, and rattan, promoting their use as reinforcement in the ordinary concrete and laterite soil. The description of the method of sizing and the process of reinforced floor to palmyra and rattan frame. The palm and the rattan wood are locally available materials in abundance in West Africa. They are part of the durable wood used for construction during the colonial period in Africa for the realization of frame floor beam of overlapping for sailing, rough framing header in the lightweight construction because they develop a stronger mechanical resistance and resist the attack of termites. The photos illustrate that palmyra wood is exploitation in abundance and implementation with big richness. This practice certainly results in the destruction of the forest of palmyra. Over-exploitation and the appearance of the concrete contributed to the abandonment of their use as ecological and economic material. However, economic construction in Africa needs are growing. Like the palm, we have the rattan vine material used extensively by the craftsmen of basketry and carpentry. Manufacturing produce have a mechanical and biological resistance. They are very durable. This bridge constructed by pygmies of Gabon illustrated the technological and biological rattan quality. With regard to all of the foregoing equation arises, can we not replace steel by rattan and palm in the reinforced concrete slab structures? Furthermore, will remaining in the context of the use of local materials, we can use the soil for compression slab and slabs in West cement. Objective of the work are optimize the volume of palmyra wood used in traditional construction. Develop hollow floors and other elements of structure weakly affected with new material involved above the palmyra, palm, rattan, concrete, and soil. Explore the possibility to replace steel in concrete by wood of palmyra and rattan in floor slabs. Promote a policy by local authority on the implementation of rattan and palm plantations to produce industrial wood. In the construction of the labor village, palm wood is used due to its biological features. In soil construction, palm wood is used for floors. In this case, it is associated with the soil to achieve the floor. Framing floor and stair for this construction of the colonial era are made in palmyra palm wood. Palmyra palm wood is used as a mound, diagonal, and rafter for the realization of farms and fire chevron as element of division. So, knowledge of physical properties on slide. Knowledge of physical properties on slide are necessary because they influence the mechanical properties and the adhesion of wood with concrete. For example, we study the absorption of the palmyra and rattan to take into account in the formulation of the concrete to prevent the release or power of concrete. The release study presented here shows that after hardening of concrete, the palmyra palm release not concrete. However, we observe a vacuum around the test piece of rattan, which leads us to conclude that rattan must be treated before being used. With regard to the use, of the palm and rattan, it is necessary to see if they behave like steel and to what extent. Therefore, we must know their elasticity limit. Comparing the values presented in the table with those of the French standard documents, it can be concluded that the palm can be assimilated to melt steel Fe215. However, rattan has a very low resistance to traction. It can be used to stabilize the soil used to make the table slab compression. With regard to results of stencil strength, we size the trowels using the Bayel standard. After you determine the stresses, those the necessary longitudinal reinforcing section. We then made the choice of frames according to the available section. We then passed to the verification of the deformation, and we find that the deformation limit is not reached. We then spin a distribution of traverse reinforcement. After this step, we sunk our trays, and after hardening of concrete, we make and use it to make floor. Then proceed to the shaping of the frames and their assembly. Implementation of half beam song, pauses of spring brick, manufacture of rattan vinyl bread, laterite gravel concrete casting. In conclusion, we just introduce you to the synthesis of an exploration study of feasibility on the possibility to use the palmera and rattan to make a modern floor. We must continue to work and lead to an application in a community building, for it is necessary determine the pull-out stress, the elasticity limit, strength, Young's modulus, and equivalent coefficient. Determine the impact of the strength of concrete on adhesion between concrete and reinforcement of palmera, and the testing of mold on the palmera and rattan. Thank you for attention.